Randy Orton did choose Mark Henry. But before you get your party started, tonight you're going to go one-on-one with Sheamus.
Teddy, ¿de qué estás hablando, Teddy?
Calm down.
¿De qué estás hablando, Ricardo?
Está loco, está loco.
Teddy, hey, hey, Teddy, te estoy hablando.
Está loco.
Esto me pertenece a mí.
He's got the best.
Esto es mío. Les dije que se le iba a quitar.
Esto es mío.
Esto me pertenece.
Well, it was Sin Cara Negro that assaulted Sin Cara Azul. One of these Sin Caras was scheduled to compete here.
Josh, did you understand any of that? Did you speak Spanish?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. And Sin Cara Negro just removed his mask.
What the hell is going on?
I mean, I can only imagine what that symbolizes. I mean,
what?
Wow. Nonetheless.
Boom, comes up Suskinner for one fall. And he's with the ring from Cape Town, South Africa, weighing in at 213 pounds, Justin Gabriel.
Trying to figure out, guys, the purpose of switching the masks. Unless Sin Cara Negro believes that he's the true Sin Cara, and this is the, I don't know.
Kind of like in those karate movies where you like take the guy's soul, maybe that's it. Right?
And from Mexico City, weighing in at 180 pounds, Sin Cara.
Okay, so are we all in agreement that Sin Cara Azul was the original Sin Cara?
No.
Well, and I believe in the history back in Mexico that, as legend goes, this Sin Cara here was
Sin
actually...
Cara Azul.
Wait, who told you that, Cole? Who told you that, first of all?
I've been doing my research, but... And this Sin Cara here, who was Sin Cara Negra, he apparently was the original Sin Cara in Mexico. Sin Cara Azul came along and actually assumed his identity.
Here
became,
in WWE.
No, in Mexico, became a huge star there.
Watch your shot.
And then when that Sin Cara moved to WWE, this Sin Cara became jealous, and hence this is where we are today. At least that's how I understand it.
Okay.
And you mentioned Mexico, Cole. Next week, the WWE will be on a whirlwind tour of Mexico, culminating with both Raw and SmackDown emanating from Mexico City. Justin Gabriel, a three-time WWE Tag Team Champion, loves to take risks. And Gabriel, there!
As to Sin Cara.
Got caught right in the sternum right there.
And now Sin Cara with the quick cover hooks the inside leg.
Yeah, purpose of this matchup, we can just call him Sin Cara because from what we understand, the other Sin Cara is undergoing medical attention
Check
right now.
Check this out right here. Sin Cara caught him midair. Right in the sternum here, and that's got to hurt.
I don't think you like this particular Sin Cara. You don't seem to get as excited about it.
I'm trying to figure out a couple of things before I actually get overexcited about this. Trying to figure out if this is the same Sin Cara in my Fade 5.
Hey, let's go, Gabe.
God, you have so much going on in your life. I don't know how you get through the whole show. You have so much in your mind.
And Sin Cara quickly taking advantage.
Man. That's him. Sin Cara is quick. He's got a mean streak, too. This is the Sin Cara right here that I said from the beginning could do it all.
In any event, Sin Cara there. Tight cover, and Sin Cara victorious.
Here is your winner, Sin Cara.
Look, I just want to go on record and say that you added absolutely nothing to that matchup.
Like I said, I was still trying to get my bearings, which one was which, but I'm going to tell you, Sin Cara's the ticket.
Which Sin Cara?